It is now time for cooking adventures with Kaity. The part of your day where Kaity comes in and cooks up an adventure. On today's episode, we will be making holiday cookies for your neighbor. If you're feeling generous. Otherwise, they are for yourself. Ha 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 ha. Hey everybody. Welcome to Cooking Adventures with Kaity, Season 2, Episode, I don't know what it is, 6, 7, 8, I think it's 8, I don't know, it's been a minute, and I've been so frazzled trying to fix my car, which was posted, probably like 2 weeks from, 2 weeks ago, at this point in time. Yeah, so I had to wash my hands a couple times before, doing this. And even then, like, my hands are absolutely beautiful, but they're clean, I promise. So, we're making sugar cookies, but we're going to be making colorful holiday cookies. So, you can make them whatever colors you want. So, you can make them Halloween cookies if you're feeling so, daring. You could make them Valentine's cookies. Whatever. But it's holidays. So, we're going to be doing festive-y colors. Festive-like colors for these cookies. You can hear the kettle in the back. I'm making some coffee because it's cold in my house. So, for the cookies, you want 2 sticks of cubed butter. It will be cold, so putting them in the freezer for a little bit to get them quite chilly is best. I'm just gonna pull them out of the fridge. You want 1 cup of sugar, 3/4 teaspoon salt, 1 teaspoon of vanilla, 4 cups of flour, and 3/4 cup of cornstarch. I do not have cornstarch, but I know you can substitute flour for the cornstarch. I think it was 2 tablespoons of flour per 1 of cornstarch, but I might just add just an extra cup of flour and just be done with it. Anyway, so you want your oven to be 375, and we'll do everything out. But what we're going to do is we're going to take this flour and portion it into 3 parts. And we're going to color 2 of the parts, and we're going to leave the other one just white, or cookie color, or whatever it is. And we're going to layer them on top of each other, roll it up, put some sprinkles out, roll that, and then cut them up and put them on the cookie sheet for baking for 12 minutes. So that's the general game plan. Pretty easy, but... yeah, so let's get started. Oh, y'all want to see some sacrilege? This right here is 5-year-old coffee from when David used to be a barista. Guess what I needed my coffee pot? Collector's item? What you say? It's going to be drinking, drunk. So I opened up the fridge and I was like, do I even have 2 sticks of butter? Barely. I barely have 2 sticks of butter. So, got this. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to take this butter and put it in the bowl with the sugar and the salt, and then we're going to cream it together. So let's get this cut up and put in the bowl. Alright, so there's the 2 sticks of butter. We need 1 cup of the sugar. And we need 3/4 teaspoons of salt. So 3 of those. So, 1 cup of sugar. 1 cup of sugar. And 3/4 teaspoon salt. Ooh, let's go crazy. Going crazy, and use the pink salt. Do 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 do. 1, 2, 3/4 teaspoon. And let me pull out the mixer and get this creamed. Alright, so let's cream this. Alright, so I, as you can see, I used the blender machine until everything was smooth, and then I just got a little soft rubber spatula and just mixing, or getting everything not quite so crumbly. So now, now that this is creamed, we want to add our 2 eggs and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Today is just a whole bunch of luck, because look at that. Lord have mercy. Alright, so we got... one. And... 2 eggs. And some vanilla. Vanilla. Well, this is imitation stuff, so... That's a teaspoon. Sure. And now we add these in. And now I'm just going to do this by hand, I think, the rest of the way. Alright, so now we add our 4 cups of flour and 3/4 cup cornstarch. But if you're me and are not prepared for anything in these days, 5 cups of flour, because there's no cornstarch. And hope it all fits into the tiny, absolutely little itty bitty bowl that I should have been better prepared for. There's 3. Oven's ready. Let's start with 4. And well, and a half. 4 and a half. I'm gonna need more flour soon. You see that? That's ridiculous. So now we mix this, but I'm gonna get this started by hand. But you want to mix it using your mixer on low until everything is well incorporated. And it starts to form a ball. But the chances of me getting a bigger bowl are very high, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that and get that out of the way. That's slightly bigger.
Just fine.
And perfect. Kind of perfect. We got this. Got it. Get that mixer going. On low until well incorporated. Alright, once things start getting like this, I would say just start using your hands. Because it's batter at this point. Loose batter. And getting everywhere, but better. So, now,
let's use our hands.
Let's get my watch off. Alright, so here's what I came out with. I honestly had a little bit more, but I don't think I had enough butter, egg, butter mainly, to be able to get everything to stick together as well as I want it to. So here's what I got. But what I have will work for the cause. So, yay! And, I mean, and it's sugar cookie dough. So, what we'll do is, and I mean, and even this is a bit dry. And I don't know if that's how it's supposed to be, but it will serve its purpose when it comes down to it. But what we'll do is we'll cut this into thirds and put it in a ball, and we'll add food coloring to give each part its unique color. So let me find that food coloring. Alright, now the sprinkles that I have are mostly a blue color, so, and because it's Christmas, we're going to do green and red. So we'll do, what you want to do is you want to put a little hole in the middle, and if you have gel food coloring, I assume it would work better. Otherwise, load that sucker in there, and mix. Alright, so this is my third round of food coloring. And I'm not exactly I'm not gonna have enough red, or I might use all of that red. Like, it might take a little bit of food coloring. But, I mean, you really gotta get in there though too, when you're mixing everything up. And such lovely counters is what I will have. Or when it comes down to it, I'm gonna have really some tie-dye cool as all get out cookies. Oh, these cookies are really neat looking. They're like, they're tie-dye. Yeah, they're supposed to be solid colors, but it works out. Hey, look at that. So, it's starting to look like we're going places. The green's getting more solid. And it's starting to be a bit more spread out throughout the dough. So if you have gel food coloring, it could very well work better. You might need less, but what I got is what I got. And green hands is what I got. And also love. Love is what I got, too. Alright. Eventually this will be done. It's never going to be as pretty as they make it out to be on Pinterest. So here's green! We're going to do red next. I do have to say, though, this looks pretty cool. But I look like I killed the Grinch. And also, yeah, I look like I killed the Grinch. Alrighty, so I got my three colors. I'm tempted to get this color too, do something with it. I've got blue and yellow left. I might just go yellow, because after adding the smidgen about of extra liquid, these are so much more malleable, and they feel like... It feels like cookie dough, where this is just kind of, it feels a little bit dry. So I think I might go yellow with that, even if it's just a little bit. And we'll do green, yellow, and red on top. So let's get that yellow going. It turned more into a conglomerate of somewhere between yellow and red, and then the white. So... yeah, we'll just go with it. So now we want to lay these out flat and make layers. All right. Round two. Alright, round three. None of these are coming out as nicely as I want them to. So, we'll just see how it comes out. All right, so now with our hopefully better staying together cookie dough than what I have in front of me because it doesn't work right now. This is frustrating. Like, I wanted to make cookies for the awesome people that helped me with my car, and they're not gonna be getting the lovely cookies that I want them to get. Or even cookies at all. Because I don't have any more butter or eggs. Boy. This is frustrating, guys. Like, seriously. Like, even if I tried to, like, because I tried to fold them nicely, even if I tried to unfold it nicely, it would just fall apart like this. So, I need more liquid and fat and stuff in my cookies, evidently. So, now I know next time, get a different cookie recipe. But, do what we can. Because as I said before, it's not Chef Kaity shows you how to do stuff. We're having cooking adventures. And like an adventure, we come across problems. And like a proper adventure person, you figure out how to handle those problems. So, let's try and roll this up. This'll be fun. There might not be sprinkles. Okay. These look absolutely horrible. I just want to go and play my video game now. Like, this is getting to be, this is a little bit ridiculous, is what this is. Because I want to make cookies. I might just make chocolate chip cookies and just be like, Merry Christmas! Because I can make chocolate chip cookies. Shoot, if I had cookie cutters, I could make sugar cookies. But this, roll it up cinnamon bun style, ain't working. Because Pinterest. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I'm just gonna roll this. It smells like Play-Doh. All right, I'm done with these. I'm gonna cut them and put them on the cookie sheet. I can already tell. Oh, thank you for the cookies. Yeah. Because that's totally what they are. So. And I'm just going to be like, happy holidays. Go away. I think that's what it's going to end up being. Happy holidays. Go away. They're supposed to be spirals. They're supposed to have sparkles on them. Sparkles. Sprinkles on them. But does that happen? No. Why? Because things don't work out. Because that was definitely not a spiral. But on the plus side, I do get some pretty neat looking cookies. They're not spirally. And they taste good. So that's good. Oh! Probably the closest I'll get to a spiral, but let's get all these on the cookie sheet.
All right, you ready? Oven for 12 minutes.
So I realize I've hit the 20 minute mark, but I'm gonna talk a little bit about sugar cookies. To my understanding. To my understanding, the batter and the eggs and everything is to be cold. It needs to be cold in order for it to be molded properly and yeah, blah, 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 blah. The recipe that I found said, don't worry about it, keep them cold, it's fine, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I don't know. It's a good recipe. It tastes good. The batter, it tastes like a sugar cookie. The batter's really dry, and I don't know if it's because maybe I needed a little bit more butter, maybe I needed the cornstarch, maybe, you know, this, that, and the other thing. Maybe I just need to tweak it a little bit, maybe just keep the cornstarch out altogether and just use the 4 cups. Or maybe 3.5 cups of flour, so it'll be a much more moist cookie dough. That's just from doing this. This being the first time I've made chocolate chip cookies. I mean, sugar cookies. I've made chocolate chip cookies before. They were in the weird dairy-free sort of way where they're done, but they look not done, but they are. The golden brown that you'd expect with regular butter is placid in comparison. So basic cookie that it looks undercooked, but it's not, and it can very easily be burnt. But you just keep an eye on the bottom, and on the bottom, if that's a brown color that is acceptable, then it's done. They weren't bad by any means. They came out quite good, but being dairy free, that. But with these, I know they're going to taste good. They look atrocious. Like, pretty cool, but not how I wanted them to, and so therefore I feel they look absolutely, they look bad. Terrible. But they're gonna taste good, and they're Christmas colors, so people will just be like, oh, this is a neat little design. Yes, thank you. I wanted them to be spirals, but they're not. So, I also wanted there to be sprinkles, but there's not. So those are cooking. They've got about 5 minutes left. So, I'm gonna come back when they're done, and we'll close out the show, and you'll be rid of me. 20 minutes is a long time, I know. Alright, well, a couple of them broke, so I can permit myself to eat one, since most of them aren't for me. But, all in all, with the dark color that it was, here's the way it ended up turning out. Which it really isn't bad, color-wise. And, I mean, in the 12 minutes, it's all the way through. They're soft. They're soft crunchy. They're soft, crunchy. But not bad. Yeah. So, thank you for watching Cooking Adventures with Kaity, season 2, I believe, episode 8. Holiday cookies. And, next time, we'll be making peppermint patties. Yeah, next time we're making peppermint patties. They may or may not be dipped in chocolate, so they may just end up being mints. But peppermint patties, and then after that, we'll be doing cream meringues. After that, we'll be doing meringues. David will be here for that. And so he may or may not be on the episode. I know he had said something to be like, to the intent of, oh, we'll totally do a cooking adventure together. And I'm like, yes. But I know when it comes down to it, he's going to be like, no. So maybe, but it'll be the peppermint patties. If not peppermint patties, they'll just be cream cheese mints and they'll be dyed. And then after that, we'll be doing meringues. And those will come out good. And then I get to deliver those in a Christmassy thingamajig to my neighbors. These cookies are going to the guys at O'Reilly's that helped me out. And they'll be going to my boss, who's pretty cool. So, yeah. Oh, and next episode, I'll have the apron that he gave me for Christmas. I have a cat apron. It's so cheesy. It's great. It's fantastic. So, thank you for watching Cooking Adventures with Kaity, season 2, episode 8, holiday cookies. Like, subscribe, comment, give me some ideas. Critique, man. Like, if I'm getting something wrong, tell me. If there's an easier way to go about something, let me know. Yeah. So, and also be on the lookout for my less family-friendly car episodes. Those will pop up from time to time. Although, my engine light is off, so since I've changed my my alternator, power steering, and my radiator all in the last week or two, hopefully there won't be any more for anytime soon, because that gets expensive really fast. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. And next time will be either peppermint patties or cream cheese mints, depending on whether I have chocolate or not. And yeah. So, happy cooking. See you around, guys. Bye.